I'm back. I'm making another video. Today, I have another jigsaw puzzle review video for you guys. Today's video is a company that is very near and dear to my heart, Bits and Pieces. So, back in the olden days, back when I was a kid in the 90s, back before online shopping was really a thing, the way that you would get specialty items that you couldn't necessarily find at the mall or locally were through catalogs. And I remember getting the Bits and Pieces catalog every single month. I loved looking through it, seeing all of the different puzzles that were available. If you saw my puzzle collection videos of all the puzzles that I had growing up, you might remember that there were a lot of Bits and Pieces puzzles in there. And they still make their catalog, they still send it out, and I still find it so fun to go through and just see in a printed form all the different like new puzzles that they have, even though obviously like we're all just gonna go and buy them online. But the reason why you're all here, let's find out what their puzzles are actually like. So this is the puzzle that I'm going to be talking about today. It is called Lighthouse Garden, and it is one of their specialty shaped puzzles. And that's just something that's a little different than other puzzles that I've done on this channel. I did the AreaWare food puzzles. Those were shaped, but I think almost everything else has just been the standard rectangle or circle or whatever. And I really love that these puzzles aren't just a standard circle or other basic shapes. They really make a custom cut based on each illustration. You can see in this page of their catalog that they have a bunch of different options. I think these are so fun. I mean, obviously, not all of their puzzles are like this. They are a big company, they have a big variety, so a lot of their puzzles are just the standard rectangle shape. But for this video, I thought it would be fun to switch it up and do a shaped puzzle. So their puzzles come shrink-wrapped, which you have to cut off. I like the box design. It's not the most modern, innovative puzzle box design I've ever seen, but it gets the job done. They have a lot of information on there, all the info that you would need about each puzzle. They have the full picture of the puzzle on the front of the box, and I like how it's this nice pastel color, so the color of the box doesn't distract from the picture that is on the puzzle. There is nothing on the back of the box, which I think is kind of a missed opportunity to have moved some of the information from the sides of the box onto the back of the box, but then that would make them more expensive to produce and more expensive for us to buy, so, you know, not a huge deal. When you open the box, there is a piece of cardboard inside to help the box keep its shape, which is nice. I mean, I always just throw that out since you don't really need it, but the boxes aren't the thickest cardboard I've ever seen. I mean, they're fine, they get the job done, but I guess this helps them not get crushed in, what's the word I'm looking for? In transit, when they're, you know, getting to you. So anyway, I always just throw that piece of cardboard into the recycling, and then the pieces come in a plastic bag that you have to cut open, and that's everything that comes in the box. So let's talk about these pieces. The Bits and Pieces puzzle pieces are super fun because they don't use the standard puzzle cut. For the shaped puzzles especially, their pieces are all over the place, and even the ones that are based on a standard puzzle cut often have exaggerated elements to them. And just to clarify, because I asked them to be sure, all of their puzzles that are 1,000 pieces and below, even the rectangular puzzles, like not just the shaped puzzles, all of those that are 1,000 pieces or below have the random piece shapes. And then all of their puzzles that are 1,500 pieces and above, those have the standard piece shapes. But this one being 750 pieces, it has the random piece shapes, and I love this. I think it's so fun to do something different once in a while, switch it up. So the printing is really bright and vibrant. The cardboard is good quality and thick enough to feel like a solid puzzle piece. And I have not had an issue with the picture peeling up from the cardboard. I will say though, there is quite a lot of puzzle dust. So if that's something that really bothers you, you might just want to know that going into it. You might want to try my little trick of putting the puzzle pieces in a colander to shake some of that dust off before you actually get started. So when it comes time to figure out your plan of attack for this puzzle, you might feel a little overwhelmed since the edge isn't quite as easy to separate out as it would be in a normal rectangular puzzle. But what Bits and Pieces has done with these illustrations is that they still included a little bit of a border, so you can still tell which pieces do go on the border. It's not quite as easy, but you know, you can do it. So I was able to separate out most of the edge pieces, and then I also just picked a color, in this case blue, and I separated out all of those colors as well. So the thing about puzzles like these with non-standard piece shapes is that they're always a little bit more difficult than you think going into it. This one, that is 750 pieces, took me about 3 hours, which, you know, it's not a crazy long time, but it's definitely longer than some easier 1,000-piece puzzles that I've done. It is a mix of not having the full border to work with, since you can't be totally sure that you've separated out all of the border pieces. And also, if you get to a tricky section, you can't use my favorite trick of separating out the pieces by shape. They're all totally different shapes, so there's not really any good way to organize them. So you really just have to power through it one piece at a time. So it is definitely more of a challenge doing a puzzle like this, since when you're trying to visualize the piece that you're looking for, in addition to visualizing what the picture on the piece is going to look like what colors and shapes you're looking for, you don't necessarily know what the full shape of the puzzle piece is going to look like. So that's just an extra challenge. One thing that I don't necessarily like about this type of puzzle piece is that sometimes you'll know where a piece goes, but it only connects on a flat section, so you have to wait until you find another piece to kind of lock the two together. And if you're moving the sections around, you just have to be extra careful that all of the pieces that aren't necessarily locked into place follow along with it. So, I mean, that can be a little frustrating if the piece gets knocked out of place, but you know, it's not a huge hassle. It's not the end of the world. Also, with this specific illustration, it is the type of puzzle where there are a lot of small sections of color, which is always more difficult than a puzzle with bigger sections of more clearly defined colors. So again, that just makes this type of, like, this style of illustration a little bit trickier than some other puzzles that I've done. So even though it is only 750 pieces, I would definitely call this a medium to hard difficulty, because you have the combination of the non-standard piece shapes and then also the kind of complex illustration. But overall, I really loved doing this puzzle. It is nice to have a challenge every so often, especially if you're super used to working with the standard puzzle piece shapes. It's fun to change it up and do something different. One thing about Bits and Pieces that I don't love is that the pieces don't lock together quite as tightly as I would like. So if you're trying to move big sections around, they kind of crumble apart a little bit more easily than I would prefer. So if you wanted to hang this up, you would definitely have to glue it together. For a shaped puzzle like this, my tape trick that I showed you a few months ago, I don't know if that would really work as well, just because you would have to make sure to cut really carefully around the outline of the puzzle to make sure that the tape isn't hanging over the edge. And that might just be a little bit more hassle than it's worth. But if you're the type of person who likes to keep your puzzles together once you finish them, this is one that you would definitely have to glue. So if you are into this puzzle and you want to try it out for yourself, I'm going to have links to where you can get it on Amazon and on the Bits and Pieces website right down below. On their website, it is currently on sale for $15, which I think is a totally fair price for what you're getting. Their standard 1,000 piece rectangle puzzles are actually even cheaper. Right now, most of them are on sale for under $10. You guys are always asking me in the comments about puzzle brands that I would recommend that are inexpensive but still good quality, and I would say Bits and Pieces definitely fits that bill. I just love how much of a huge variety of puzzles they have in lots of different styles of illustrations. I love that they're available on Amazon. It makes it really easy to buy them. And I love that you're not going to break the bank if you stock up on a few of these. So I would love to know in a comment right down below if you have ever done a Bits and Pieces puzzle or what you thought of it. If you're watching all the way to the end, your code word for the comments, so that I know you're watching the entire thing, it's going to be Lighthouse, okay? And then I'll see your comment and you'll just be my favorite puzzler in the world. So that's everything I had to say. I'm gonna go. Thank you for watching and happy puzzling.